The heat collecting ability of a hot air collector is related to the difference between the input and output temperature, and also related to the quantity of air pushed through the system. But how can we estimate the flow rate of a fan? A simple method of measuring the CFM of a fan involves measuring the length of time it takes to fill a plastic bag with air. Unfortunately, estimating when a bag is full and estimating the volume of air in a bag is difficult. Fortunately, Nick Pine suggested a method that uses the relationship between electrical energy and heat energy. Since 1 watt-hour of electrical energy is the equivalent to 3.4 BTUs, a heat-producing incandescent bulb may be used to measure the flow rate of a fan with the help of a load box, a thermostat, and a thermometer. By measuring the electrical energy needed to maintain a given temperature in a closed box and by comparing this energy to the energy used to maintain temperature in an open box, the CFM of a fan can be calculated. My name is John Canavan, and this is Mr. Muffin Fan, and we'd like to know what the flow rate of Mr. Muffin Fan is in cubic feet per minute, CFMs. Now, one way of figuring this out would be to plug Mr. Muffin Fan into Mr. PVC pipe and inflate Mr. Plastic Bag over here. So let's try this. Now, when I plug this in, I want you to count the number of seconds it takes to inflate this bag. You ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, it took about 5 seconds to inflate Mr. Plastic Bag. But we also have to know what the volume of this bag is. It's approximately 2 cubic feet, but I don't really know exactly. It's a very crude method of estimating the flow rate of a fan. As you know, the flow rate of a fan is an important consideration when it comes to calculating the performance of a hot air collector. We need to know not only the input temperature and the output temperature from the collector, but we also need to know the flow rate. That's a measure of heat. Anyway, so we'll be using a light bulb to actually calculate the flow rate. What you're looking at is something called a load box, and we're using the load box to measure the flow rate of this fan. With this fan, we're blowing air across a 200 watt light bulb, and when the air blows across the light bulb, it's taking the heat from the light bulb, blowing it through the box and back out across these temperature probes. So what we're going to do is we're going to measure how long the light bulb stays on to maintain a constant temperature inside the box. Now there's a mouthful for you. So the actual temperature inside the box is not really that important. What we're interested in is the difference in the temperature between the ambient temperature and the load box temperature. And you can see this is a digital thermometer here. I'll tell you what that is right now. That's just about 64 degrees, 63.7, something like that. Anyway, so we're maintaining a temperature inside the load box of 64 degrees. The ambient temperature is 54 degrees, so we have a differential temperature of 10 degrees. That'll make it easy for our calculations. So what we want to know right now is the length of time that the light comes on compared to the total time interval. Okay, the temperature inside our load box has stabilized. It stabilized at about 64 degrees. Okay, so that's about 10 degrees higher than the ambient temperature. Now, it's still off. All it's doing is circulating the air through the box. So as soon as it comes on, we'll measure the length of time that it's on. So the on time is 9 seconds, and the total time between intervals is 135 seconds. Let's first take a look at the heat gain of a closed load box heated with a 200 watt light bulb. Air from the fan is circulated over the bulb to pick up heat. When the heat circulation chamber is placed over the input and output holes on top of the load box, heat from the bulb is circulated inside the closed loop with the help of a fan. A thermostat is used to turn the bulb on and off to maintain a constant load box temperature. Now, let's open the load box. When the heat circulation chamber is removed, outside air is blown over the bulb and the hot air in the load box is vented. The lowered air temperature activates the thermostat and turns on the light bulb to maintain the constant temperature. The on time of the bulb is a measure of the energy consumed by the 200 watt bulb. The duty cycle of a light bulb is the on time divided by the total on and off time. If the bulb is on for 18 seconds and off for 18 seconds, the duty cycle is 50%, and the energy consumption of a 200 watt bulb would be 100 watt hours or 340 BTUs. A closed load box will of course take less electrical energy to maintain temperature than an open load box, and the difference between the open box heat energy requirement and the closed box heat energy requirement measures the heat contained in the air moved by the fan. If we know the electrical energy used to maintain a constant load box temperature and the input and output temperatures of the fan, we can calculate the flow rate of the fan. From the data collected, we can calculate the CFM of the fan. We found the duty cycle of the bulb in the closed box was 7%, and 7% of 200 watts is 14 watts. We found the duty cycle of the bulb in the open box was 50%, and 50% of 200 watts is 100 watts. The difference between the light bulb heat energy consumed by the open box and the light bulb heat energy consumed by the closed box is the heat energy moved by the fan. This would be 100 watt hours minus 14 watt hours, or 86 watt hours, or 292 BTUs. From this information and the differential temperature information, we can calculate the CFM of the fan. First, we'll calculate the weight of air moved by the fan in an hour. This would be 292 BTUs divided by the product of the heat capacity and the differential temperature. From this calculation, we find that 152 pounds of air are moved by this fan every hour. If we divide the weight of the air by 0.075, we have the cubic feet of air moved during this interval of time. From here, it's a simple matter to estimate the flow rate of the fan to be 34 cubic feet per minute.